Hello, everybody. This is Joe Williams, and I've got a few of my favorite songs coming right up. So stand by, America. Here's your Stars for Defense.
Yes, ladies and gentlemen, it's your Stars for Defense with Ray Block and his orchestra, yours truly, Jay Jackson, and today starring Joe Williams. Stars for Defense is presented by this station every week as a public service in cooperation with the Office of Civil Defense. Regular Stars for Defense listeners have heard and learned a good deal about our nation's civil defense planning. Today, you'll hear about the steps being taken in other countries to guard against the potential dangers of this nuclear age. Now, ladies and gentlemen, Stars for Defense welcomes back one of America's great vocal artists, the swinging Mr. Joe Williams.
Blue skies smiling at me, nothing but blue skies do I see. Blue birds singing a song, nothing but blue birds all day long. I never saw the sun shining so bright, never saw things going so right. Noticing the days hurrying by, when you're in love, my, how they fly. Blue days, all of them gone, nothing but blue skies from now on. Nothing but blue birds all day long. I never saw the sun shining so bright, I never saw things going so right. But noticing the days hurrying by, when you're in love, my, how they fly. Blue days, oh, all of them gone, nothing but blue.
Joe Williams with Irving Berlin's Blue Skies. A very happy song for a man who usually sings the blues.
Well, it's a kind of a blues number, Jay. At least the sky is. Seriously, I do get to sing a lot of blues songs. I always did during my years with Count Basie, but I enjoy a happy song now and again.
Well, Joe, you're singing any kind of song, old or new, happy or blue, makes us happy. So how about another?
One great Irving Berlin tune always deserves another.
Right, Joe. So how about doing your arrangement of Always right now?
Right now, Mr. Jackson. Ready, Mr. Block? Everything went wrong, and the whole day long, I feel so blue. For the longest while, I'd forget to smile that I met you. Now that my blue days have passed, now that I've found you at last, I'll be loving you always with a love that's true. Always, when the things you plan need a helping hand, I will understand. Always, always, days may not be fair. Always, that's when I'll be there. Not for just an hour, not for just a day, not for just a year, but always. Mm-hmm. just an hour, not for just a day, not for just a year, but always.
Thanks, Joel. Now, a word from Civil Defense. One question keeps popping up. If there's really a need for civil defense, how come we're the only ones worrying about it? Why aren't any of the other nations doing anything about fallout shelters? Well, it's true, you don't see much, if anything, about it in the papers. But the actual fact is, a good many countries are doing something about civil defense, and in some cases, even more than we are. Russia, for one. They don't advertise it to the outside world, but a good deal of evidence has been uncovered to show they're making extensive efforts to strengthen their civil defense. Or to take those two traditionally neutral countries, Sweden and Switzerland. Sweden is a leading example of a country that has extensive industrial and public shelters, many of them dug deep in rock to provide blast as well as fallout protection. And Switzerland, peaceful but always prepared, just recently passed legislation requiring shelter for everyone. All in all, six European countries have either new or long-standing mandatory shelter programs, and three more are considering adopting such plans. As a recent NATO resolution stated, and I quote, "The chances for survival under nuclear attack for nations, communities, and families can be significantly improved in the North Atlantic community by adequate programs for fallout protection. Measures to enlarge the proportion of survival among the peoples of the NATO countries would also increase the capability for international cooperation in accelerating recovery from a nuclear war," unquote. In short, our country is not alone in recognizing the potential dangers of the nuclear age and in taking sensible precautions to guard against them. Now back to music as Ray Block takes the spotlight. Ray, put the spotlight down for a minute and tell us what you and the band have on tap.
I don't know what the band has on tap, but I have...
Joe Williams, it's all yours.
A little earlier, Jay, you said something about songs old or new. Well, I've done a couple of fine oldies, so I thought we'd wind up things with a newie.
A newie?
A new song, a good song, and it's by Mar Fisher and Jack Siegel, and it's called Good Thing.
Well, good. Let's hear it.
in its time, so the wise men say. And that old cliche must contain more than a grain of truth. At least it did for this callow, naive, and shallow youth. Isn't it a good thing that you never came my way? When I was young and wild and careless, falling in and out of love each day, I have never seen the beauty in you, nor had the sense to try to win you, never knowing what to do or what to say to make you stay. Isn't it a good thing? What growing pains can do. I'm glad that loneliness and heartache taught me just how much I needed you. I could never have adored you so long if I had met you long ago, love. But I know a good thing when I see it now.
For the past 15 minutes, you've been listening to Stars for Defense, a transcribed feature presented as a public service by this station every week in cooperation with the Office of Civil Defense. Today, our star was Joe Williams, to whom we extend our sincere thanks for a fine performance. It has been said, the new civil defense program is not a panacea. Certainly, it is no substitute for relentless negotiation and positive efforts on all our parts to achieve peace. But neither are these a substitute for fallout shelters. It has never been and never will be regarded as cowardly, foolhardy, or immoral for people and communities to exert every effort to protect their families against any threat, Indians, fires, flood, or fallout. We owe it to ourselves to take out at least this minimal insurance against disaster. And now this is Jay Jackson inviting you to join us next week for some more good music by Ray Block and his orchestra and another famous star on Stars for Defense.